worship you, we worship you. Surround me.
Let your presence. Thank you.
come running to your presence, God. To drink from the waters that you have freely given. Lord, we pray, touch us now again with your grace. We pray, touch us now. I've not abandoned you. I'm not indifferent to you. Father, we thank you for your presence. God, we thank you for your anointing. Thank you for touching each and every one of us. Thank you, Jesus, that we rejoice in you. We rejoice in you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Father, we worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory, glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus, for your presence. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, I hear God is looking for a passionate bride. Passionate bride. Hallelujah. It's a passionate bride. Father, we're passionate about you. We're passionate in our praise. We're passionate in our worship. God, we are passionate for you. We are passionate in our love for you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, I thank you for burning in us a zeal. Hallelujah. A zeal for God's house. A zeal for you, Lord. A zeal for you, Jesus. A zeal for worship. A zeal for worship. A zeal for worship. A zeal for worship, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for the anointing. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for breakthrough. I thank you for your blessing of your presence. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. Thank you for your presence, God. Thank you for your presence, God. Thank you for your presence, God. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for touching us. Thank you for your presence, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Ramasanda Lebokosototo. Oh, Ramasata. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, oh, Ramasata. Oh, oh, Ramasata. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, oh, my house shall be called a house of prayer. Oh, 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 Jesus, we worship you. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, my house shall be called a house of prayer. Oh, Father, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Oh, Rabasandalebokosoto. Oh, Jesus, hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, we come to meet with you. We come to meet with you. We come to commune with you. Oh, God, I thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Oh, Ramasandale. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you for the wind of the Spirit. Thank you for the wind of the Spirit. Thank you for the anointing, God. Thank you for your presence. Thank you, Jesus, for touching us. Thank you, Jesus, for showing yourself. Thank you, God, for manifesting your presence amongst us. Oh, Rabba Shandale, yeah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Jesus. Oh, Rabba Shandale, oh, Rabba Shandale, oh, in you we move. In you we live. In you we have our being, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In you we move, in you we live, in you we have our being. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. We commune with you, God. Oh, Ramashandale Babo, so Rabababashi. Hey, Brabababashanai. Oh, Ramashandale Babo, so. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Rabashandale Babo, so. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's the anointing. It's the anointing. It's the anointing. It's the anointing. Oh, Ramasandale Babasso Tolokoso. Hallelujah. Arabasandale Bababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababababab
called us. It is Christ that gives the increase. It is Christ that gives the increase. It is the anointing. It is Jesus that changes us. It is Jesus that changes us. Hallelujah. Oh, Rabashandale Boboboso. Thank you, Lord, that we get our increase from you. We get our increase from you. We get our increase from you. Oh, Rabashandale Boboso. Let's lift our hands. Father, we thank you so much for your beautiful presence. Thank you, Master. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God, we worship you. Father, we don't want to move one step unless you move it, Jesus. We don't want to move one step without you. We don't want to go one place without you. If we stand still, we stand still. If we sit, we sit. Jesus. Holy Spirit, I pray that you have your way. Have your way. Have your way. Thank you, Jesus. Whew. Felt a shift. Whew. It's good to follow the Holy Ghost. Amen. Thank God that we have a church with a pastor that follows the Holy Ghost. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Woo. Whew. Well. Whew. It's good to drink from the well. It is good to drink from the well. The Samaritan woman had a Jesus encounter. And Jesus revealed himself to her. I find it very interesting that it's in the midst of the topic of worship. I believe that when we worship God, we draw forth from that well. And we have a revelation and an eye-opening experience with Jesus. Amen? I've been doing an exhaustive, or maybe exhausting, study. And a few months ago, I asked the Lord, I was like, God, what is it all about? What is it all about? And I felt like the Lord really came through with a resounding answer, and it was fellowship. That it's all about fellowship with him. Everything he did was to bring us back to him. Man, that's awesome. Whew. Whew. In the beginning, this is the Gospel of John, verse 1. In the beginning, from what we know as the beginning, the point of creation was the word. I have found that the English language is a bit lacking in how to describe or how to really paint the picture, I think, that the Holy Spirit wants to paint for us. The simple word was means it was already in existence from the point that the beginning started. The word was eternal. Eternal. It's a bit windy up here, so my pages are flying off. And the Word was with God. Another simple phrase. But if we just read it, and the Word was with God, that's like me, I rode in the car with my mom. What happened while I was with her? The Word was in fellowship, communion with God. They communed. And the Word was God. And then he says it again. And the same, in other words, God, was in the beginning with God. So he says, in the beginning, before there was a beginning, God and God, the Word, were fellowshipping amongst each other. They had relationship. It was communion. This just starts to get a little bit of an itch of what he's looking for with us. The word that's spoken here is logos. Logos means more than just a word or the written word. It is a compilation of thoughts, in its conception in the mind and the expression of them. So it's not just like just the word, it's God's thought process. It's God's reasoning. His mind being manifested. Man. Have you ever stopped? Excuse me. I had to do that. That was a must. The Septuagint says this. about the Ten Commandments. It doesn't say the Ten Commandments. It says the Ten Words. It's interesting how God says, I'll no longer write them on tablets of stone, but I'll put my word in their hearts. That's my Jesus he's talking about. That's my Jesus. He'll put Jesus in my heart. That which was with God, communing with God, is now come to live inside of me and bring me along with him so I can commune with God too. With God, living in union or in fellowship with God, a unison. The Word was God, making a distinction of persons, but an equality of essence. Man, there's no doubt that Jesus is God. The same was in the beginning with God, meaning that God with God is fellowship in an eternal active communion. In him was life. It was the source of life. The source, and the word life there is there's two different words that it uses, and one is for animal life. And another one is another level of existence which he prescribed man. And the life was what? I don't know how Pastor Jay does this. All things were made by him, and in and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. The word light is not just illuminating. It's the ability to receive that which is divine. So Jesus comes as the Word of God. And in the beginning, this is what happened in the garden. They had fellowship and walked in the garden together in the cool of the day. That sounds like my kind of day. So there was a communion together with God and with man because God's life was on the inside, and the life was the illumination, or his spirit was alive to God so he could receive everything that God had for him. But the enemy came with temptation. The enemy came to try and steal God's plan, just like he's done ever since. What's he after? The Word. What is he after? The Word. Excuse me. And the light shineth. Notice everything has really been a past tense thing. But he says, and the light shineth. That's because it's not past tense. It's still shining. Whew. And it shineth in darkness. And the darkness comprehended it not. The word comprehend is the same exact word for apprehend, took it or overtook it. So the darkness did not overtake the light, but the light is victorious. Glory to God. It did not overtake it. So in the beginning, this may have happened. The enemy came in, but guess what? God's light still wins. Glory. Glory to God. Man, that's powerful. The darkness did not comprehend it. I'm thinking, well, I knew the devil was dumb. But comprehend, not the right English word to use. It didn't overtake it. It didn't overtake the light. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Whew. Okay. All right, so foundation. God's word. Everything that was made, we know was made by the word of God. He said, let us bring forth man in our image. Right? Let us bring forth man in our image. And man came out. Man. Spirit. Made in his image. We are spirit. We are spirit beings. Well, what's been born again? Well, it was like it was born one time, way back in the garden when he breathed into man. When the word of God spoke and he said, let us bring forth. The same word came, manifested in the flesh. We call him Emmanuel. God is with us. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 22, verse 23 says, you are born again by the, not by corruptible seed, but by that which is incorruptible, by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. Man, that's good. I got a spirit on the inside that's been born from seed that liveth and abideth forever. That is good. Man, don't look in the mirror. Don't look quite the same, but praise God that our inward man is renewed daily. Woo! Let's sit on that for a while. Okay, all right, 1 John. So we got the foundation. We know that we were born or made by the word of God. Spiritually, there was death that entered. But darkness did not prevail. That's good news. John, he says so himself, that he was the disciple that Jesus loved. And he said it, so I believe it. If there's anything I want to get from this man, is his revelation of God. He knows the Lord. This man laid on Jesus' chest. There's something he has for us. First Epistle of John, verse 1. That which was from the beginning, again, he says, that which was, before there even was a beginning, he was in existence. Which we have heard, which we have seen with our eyes. The word heard and have seen are in what's called perfect tense. What that means is I've heard him at one time, but the effects of hearing him haven't stopped me. I'm still hearing him today, and I'm planning on hearing him tomorrow. I just saw him yesterday. I saw him today. I'm going to see him tomorrow. That's what it means. It's perfect tense. Perfect past, perfect present, perfect future. Whew. Something happened to John, and it's amazing because this is the man that walked with Jesus. But he talks about a spiritual experience first. He talks about that first. We always sit back and say, boy, I wish I was one of those. At least I do. I said, man, it'd be nice to be Peter and cut that dude's ear off. Just, oh, sorry. Here you go. So John, he sits there and he says, that which we have heard and we have seen. And the reason he says with our eyes is it denotes not everybody. It's personal. With my own eyes, I've had a personal experience that changed my life and changed my hearing. From now on, he spoke to me once, and from then on, I've never been the same. That which we have looked upon, which is the historic sense. So it's looking upon Jesus in the history. And that which we have handled, which I've actually touched. So the very last thing he says is that I touched them, I walked with them. But the first thing he says is the born again experience at that time that Jesus spoke, just like he did to Peter, and he says, I am the Christ. He says, he took to Peter and he says, flesh and blood hasn't revealed that to you, but my Father which is in heaven. Revelation. Light. Man, that's powerful. For the life was manifested, have looked upon, and our hands have handled of the word of life. For the life was manifested. The word manifested, instead of like the word became flesh, this life was manifested, not just the incarnate side of Jesus, but the whole process of how to get life was manifested. Him being incarnate, him being crucified, and him being raised from the dead. It was manifested. And we have seen it and bear witness. Once again, the seen it is the same thing. I saw it, I've never seen the same. And bear witness means you can see the fruit. I bear it. It's fruit bearing. You can look at me. You can see something's changed me. You can see my life is in him now. I wasn't the same John before that I am now. Something's happened and changed. I have fruit. I bear witness, or I bear record. It's an external bearing. And I show unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father and was manifested unto us. The word eternal life is not just the duration of time. It is the quality of life that we can have with God being Christians. It is not just length. It is quality. It is God's life. That which we have seen and heard. This time he says seen and heard. He uses the more dominant. He says, I'm letting you know this is for sure. That which we have seen and heard, declare we unto you, that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly, our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. So the word fellowship comes from the root word koinonia, which is the same word for communion, which is the same word for the intimacy as between a man and a woman. It's being joined in oneness. And he says that I want you to have fellowship with me because my fellowship is with God and with Jesus. So we can have an intimate relationship with God and with Jesus because we received our Lord. This then, and these things we write unto you, that your joy may be full. So as a Christian, I'm writing unto you whatever I'm about to say, Whatever he's about to say, it's that our joy would be full in our walk with God. This then is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you, that God is what? Light. And in him is what? No darkness at all. Not one bit. If we say, he includes himself. He doesn't say, well, if you all say. If that church over there says. He says, if we say that we have fellowship with God and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. The light here means it's like a moral goodness. It's goodness. It's walking in good morality. Soundness. Darkness here is immorality. What he's saying is, if you're telling me that you're having an intimate time with God daily, and the word walk there, it means perpetuo, perpetual. It's a perpetual walk of darkness. He's not talking about if you make a mistake. He's talking about a perpetual walk of darkness. You're telling me, he says, you're telling me, he says, if I told you that I was fellowshipping, having intimacy with God and with Christ, and walking perpetually in sin, I'm lying to you. And I'm not doing what I said I was. It's true. It got really quiet in here. I'm even not wanting to say anything. I wanted to share this. The word worship. So fellowship means koinonia, intimacy. Intumisi, I like to say. Worship means, is translated proskuneo. The word pros is literally means towards. The word koinonia means kiss. When we worship God, I believe it's the first step in the beginning of fellowship with him. Intimacy. It's leaning towards him in reverence and giving him a kiss. That's beautiful. We don't have to wait until we're in heaven to kiss our Lord. Amen? We can kiss him. He's awesome. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. If we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. Now, one with another right there, he's talking about fellowship. You're fellowshipping with us again. But what's his fellowship? His fellowship's with God and with Jesus. So the point is there's a unity in the Spirit that happens. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another. You cannot separate the two. If you have fellowship with God and with Jesus, you're going to walk in love and fellowship with your brothers, and you're not going to walk in sin. Why? Because light removes darkness. So any bit of darkness, and see, oh man, I'm getting ahead of myself. If we say that we have no sin, what happens? We deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. How many times, at least I have found it for myself, where you go through a tough time, you fall, you maybe collapse in some people's situations, you know? Yeah, you know, do the cross thing, but on your face, you know, it's like, you know, I mean, it's bad. What we have a tendency of doing, just as Adam and Eve did, is running from God. But that's not the answer to get rid of any darkness. To get rid of darkness, we got to run to God. We got to run to the light. So just because, no, just, you said, oh, I sinned, I can't get anywhere near God right now. I can't do what he wants. He don't love me. No, that's not it. He wants to fellowship with you. He wants you to run to him right now. Confess your sins. You've been forgiven and cleansed from all unrighteousness. Run to Jesus so he can get that out of your life. The more we spend time with him, the more we become like him. God is light, and in him is what? An intimacy is one joining in another. In him is what? No darkness. If I don't want any darkness, where do I got to go? To the light. Man, praise God. Whew. I could jump if I didn't weigh almost 300 pounds. My little children, these things write I unto you that you sin not. So whatever he just said was the answer to overcome sin. He's not just telling you don't sin. He's telling you the way not to. It's not by staying out of church. It's not by staying out of worship. It's not by staying out of the presence of God. How many times does the accuser set you up and say, oh, look what you did. But after he tempted you to do it. Guy is a psychopath. He wants you to taste that. This is really good. Dummy, why'd you do that? Right? But God loves you. My little children. It gets really hot up here. Oh, yes. Music is on. That was awesome. That was like, man, was that, I mean, come on. You know that's God. You know that's God. So my little children, these things write I unto you, that you sin not. And if any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. Man, praise God. This is not talking about your salvation. It's talking about fellowship. That's what God wants. That's what God wants from us. What do you think it's all about? Right? That's how it was in the garden. Walking in the cool of the day with God. Yeah, what you doing, Adam? Just hanging out with God. Really? Really? It's the intimate places that God has called us to. It's the secret places that God has called us to. It's the place when we get home and we say, Lord, I just need my time with you. Let me turn down the lights. Let me take off my shoes. I love leaning toward my Father and giving Him a kiss. So we partake of Jesus' life. We're born again. We were dead, but we were alive, and we were dead, and now we're born again. We were dead to God, but now we're alive to God. What for? To fellowship with Him. My God, I think He cries out and says, spend time with me. I know it. It's interesting. In John, it later on talks about walking in love. And it equates to it as walking in darkness. Why? Because God is not only light, but God is also what? Love. So if I'm having an intimate relationship with love, but somehow I'm hating perpetually my brother. Because, I mean, there's been some days, but it wasn't perpetual, but there were times. But there's a perpetual bitterness, a perpetual unforgiveness, a perpetual hatred. And yet I say, yeah, I spent a lot of time with God today. You're lying. And you're doing not what you said you would. That's why it's a double negative. You're lying, and you're doing not the truth. If you were doing it, the other stuff would be just coming out. You can't tell me that we spend an hour or 2 hours in the presence of the Lord and not get changed. After Jesus was gone, the scribes and the Pharisees saw Peter. After he was gone. And they said, weren't these his uneducated idiots? They've been with Jesus. They don't talk uneducated. They talk like they know something. They must have been with Jesus. That's after he was gone. It's just, it's intimate right here. And even John says even more so. That we can have with God just as intimate with God as when they were walking right side by side. That is good. So he says, little children, just going to close with this. So about the love of God, same thing. We're joined one spirit with Him, fellowship with Him. And he talks about a progression in the Christian life. And he says, little children, young men, and fathers. Little children, young men, and fathers. There's a progression when we walk with the Lord. A lot of young Christians, I had a good friend of mine. When I was really young, he said, when I was like 17, I had a good buddy of mine. And he said, Ryan, I'll come to the Lord when I get my stuff cleaned up. Dude, you can't do that. You just got darkness, man. You need light. So he says, little children, your sins are forgiven you. Young men, you are strong and overcome the wicked one. Fathers, you've known Him who is from the beginning. I want to be a father. I want to be a father. I want to know him intimately, who was from the beginning. Amen? Everyone get anything out of tonight, I hope? That is my message. Pastor Joel never ends it quite like that. I got to work on the ending stuff. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for your word. God, we know you said, as Peter said, as newborn babes desire the sincere milk of the word. Another word, desire, that just doesn't do it justice. I've never seen a baby desire milk. They fight and claw at it and scream and cry until they have it. God, we need to be that hungry. We want to be that hungry for you. Father, forgive us for not taking the time to fellowship with you when we should have taken time to fellowship with you. Father, forgive us for not turning off the TV when we should have turned it off and come into your presence, Lord, with singing and with thanksgiving. Jesus, I just ask you right now that you would anoint us afresh with a hunger and a zeal to pursue you. With a hunger and a zeal, God, to pursue walking with God. That we would learn to walk the walk of the Spirit. God, that we would learn to, with unfeigned love, unfeigned sincerity in our heart, come before you in worship. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that you just touch us tonight. God, as the psalmist said, God, create in me a clean heart and renew a right spirit within me. God, renew, God, restore the joy of our salvation. God, restore the joy of our salvation. God, that early in the morning we'll wake the sun. Early in the morning, God, we'll come and we'll run and we'll walk in worship to you, Lord. We'll run, God. Or like they said, is, let us be glad. God, I was glad when they said unto me, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go unto the house of the Lord. Father, I just pray right now that you touch everyone here. God, that we don't have to wait till we get to heaven to give you a kiss. We don't have to wait. That's what this eternal life is about. It's right now. It's right now. It doesn't start in heaven. It starts right now. It's eternal life. It's fellowship with God. The life came. God's word came for something. It didn't just come for nothing. It came to bring us back so we could have fellowship with you. God, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that your anointing would touch us, that you would change us, that your spirit would work in us, God, both to will and to do for your good pleasure, Jesus. We love you and we worship you. I'd like to invite anyone that would like prayer. It is something that I love to do. So if you'd like personal ministry, I'm more than willing to pray for you and would love to. And if there's anyone in here that needs to recommit their life to the Lord, it's a heart decision. If anyone needs to turn from seeking intimacy with others to having intimacy with God, there's no recordation of heaven. God's not keeping a tally and saying, oh, yeah, you missed it there. He's washed us completely clean. You know, the word cleanse means actually removed. It's not, the old was an atonement, it covered. The blood of Jesus removes the sin. It completely removes it. I'm not just covered, I'm cleansed. Right? So I encourage you, I encourage myself in the Lord, that we run to our Master and fellowship with Jesus on a daily basis. If it's a walk of darkness, he said we could have a walk in light. We know that God is light. So we can have a walk in God every day. Amen? Amen. Be blessed in the name of the Lord. If you want to leave, you want to go, if you want prayer, I'd be more than happy to pray with you.